Welcome back, folks. My name is Mead, and you're watching Forgecraft. I see I got a block out of place there. Oh, I sure did. Yeah, that's alright. We'll come back to that in a bit. What I'm doing right now is... we'll show you the other bit in a minute, but... this is the only place where the packaging, the materials that are going to be packaged, they have to be specified somewhere, because otherwise, I guess I could send everything through the packaging system, and if it didn't want a package, it would just spit it back out. But that seems kind of silly, and it's much better to just have a single piece here. Then have to worry about keeping 9 in a filter somewhere or something like that. So this is where we're going to do the filtering for the Psychorium, at least, and we'll add stuff as we get to it. I'm in the process of pulling stuff out of here and sending it back through and letting it run. And what we're going to need to do is get all of these. And we can test the overflow system as well. So let's see if we can put these in here. We've already got them marked. And there they go. Light blue. And they're going to go straight. You can probably see they're going to go straight over there. Let's go check that out. Yeah, server lag. Here, this is what we're dealing with. 29%. So that's what happens when it's not timed well enough for the server ticks. And it skips a tick, and then all of a sudden, you know, you're just kind of stuck with it. So this may not work. This may not work at all. I guess we're going to find out. Yeah, see, there we've got some. We've got a little bit bouncing back. And where is that going to go? It has nowhere to go. So it's going to bounce around in the tube until... see, this is why I set this up to only run 27 times instead of just until the chest is empty. Because now we've got... yep, there we go. Because now we've got the chest starting to fill up again. And I suppose it's still running, or are we done? That doesn't look like all of it. No, it's still going. We've still got... yeah, that filter's still running. Yep, see, there go some blocks right there. Pretty cool. Oh good, here comes the garbage truck, so we'll be back. Okay, that's taking rather longer than I thought for this filter to actually work on this chest. But that turned out to be about right. And I guess it's just the way the server's crapping out, and it's just taking a lot longer. But I'm glad to see that this is working. See, that's why I didn't want to rely on timers or anything like that. So it won't matter. It'll just run a little slower. But it doesn't do anything until it detects an item that's already in the system. So that's pretty cool. And we'll leave that open just for now. And I have no idea how I'm going to fix this. Probably just, I don't know, I'll tear it down or something. It's like we're not able to... this is why we can't have nice things. I mean, even with the massive server hardware, I don't know what's going on. We're getting 5 ticks per second. Ugh. Alright, so let's go ahead. And we've got... okay, we've got space for those. Light Psychorium, alright. Cool. We'll just send all this junk through. You can hear it working in the background. Pretty cool. There go blocks. Blocks aplenty. And once I get done with all of the multi-stack, like, you know, changing over 13 stacks of these and 11 stacks of those and whatever, it's going to be a lot easier, even with the sorting machine, even with the quarry running, rather. It just won't be coming in such a quantity that it's going to really overflow anything, especially over there in the packager. So, rain, go away. I do kind of miss seeing the rain and the snow and all that stuff, but I don't miss the sound, so it can just go. So let's see. Those might be coming in. What am I doing? I think I'm watching the wrong thing. This is what I need to be doing, and it's getting dark. Hey, at least the light is up, so it'll help light the place up. Yeah, we're nowhere near done with that. Yeah, see, this is what I was talking about with the overflow. But this is why I made this an iron chest and not, well, I couldn't have made it a wooden, but I could have made it a copper or something else, but you'll want to make it at least an iron chest. Because, you know, if you're dumping a bunch of stuff into the system, this chest might fill up again like it's about to do. And then you would need somewhere for it to go, otherwise it would just sit in the pipe and potentially screw things up. So this is working through its stuff fast enough. We're getting, what, seven? Yeah, seven blocks. And then it goes and dumps off, you saw we had three. I think it's doing red. All right. And I'm rambling. Mainly because I just woke up. Still sipping on my coffee. Man, I had a lot of coffee yesterday. Let me tell you, I had that job interview, which went really well. The only thing is, he's not in a position to. Well, I mean, I guess he could. Wait, what's going on here? What in the world is going on there? Oh, good. Now I've got this to deal with. And I don't have a... Well, I guess I do have this. Oh, shit. I just screwed up somebody's thing here. Yeah, let's fix this, and then... Okay, so, scaffold. There we go. Might be slightly in the wrong place, but whatever, it's close enough. But yeah, he said it would be probably a couple of 3 weeks. Yeah, I think I put that in the wrong place. That's all right. Until he could figure out what, you know, where to put me, basically. But as far as I can tell, I have a position. I have a job with him. So we're getting there. We've already got over a stack each of the red and green, and I think we're done with the red and green, just about. Maybe not quite yet, but we will be soon. We're getting some... What is that, Z-fighting? You could see it earlier on the chest over here, on the packager, where it was turning light and dark. Yeah, I don't know what that's about. Maybe that's Optifine, maybe it's not. Who knows? But Optifine works for me. There's a very, very few graphical glitches, mainly on custom textures, like the ores, like the Zycraft ores, act kind of weird, like that, and this. And you know, that's not enough for me to want to even want to stop using it. It's just not that big a deal. I mean, for all I know, that could be a lighting thing. Who knows? But we should have this running again. Yep, there they go. Yeah, the only thing that I would like to see is a chest that, or some kind of something that, how do I explain this? It will shift, like it would be a hopper, like a 27 thing hopper, and when you take a block, when you take a stack out of this, all the rest of these shift down. So all the new stuff comes in at the end. That would be nice to have. Because right now this is another minor flaw in this system, is that the filter that's pulling stuff out 27 times is going to grab the singles, or, you know, the partials from this system, if it happens to get put in at the same time. Because it'll start to, you know, if this is full and it starts pulling stacks out, and this starts running, and it puts in this 4 Zycorium here in an empty slot, the filter is going to take this instead of continuing to take these full stacks. But it will all sort itself out eventually. It'll just take a little longer. So we've got the white and blue Zycorium going through now. Excellent. All right, well, my aura... We were going to do some Thumbcraft stuff, but somebody else in the area has been... There's somebody over there, as you saw earlier, with the scaffolding and the thing. They've got, you know, somebody's... not sure who it is. Like, this person over here, maybe we should go look at that. Let's go find out who's over here. So it's getting dawn. I don't have my sword, but that's all right. Apparently now we're sharing this aura. Yes, yes. Alright. Now. This might all still be players' stuff. That's a lot of flowers. That is an amazingly large amount of flowers. Yeah, it looks like... Yeah, all of this is, I think all of this is players' stuff. But, regardless, the aura is high. Oh, it's 55, somebody planted a tree. Yep, the aura is 55 over here, but, what is this? That's interesting. And, ooh, Kapok. Oh, wow, I haven't seen Kapok in a long time. That's been from a completely different mod. We haven't seen, can I do this? Nope. It was working with one of the tools, and I forget which it was. No matter. There we go. Haven't seen that since Terraformacraft. And I don't know, I've been thinking about going back to that. I haven't looked. I need to go look and see if there's enough new there's enough new stuff to justify a whole new series on it. Because, you know, I did that for 5 months. And 5 months straight. And I kind of got to the point where I thought that I had done everything that I possibly could. And I was sort of just resorting to building. You know, like the pool and the houses and, you know, just using different woods and different stuff like that. And it just felt like it was getting old. So that's why I came back to mods. But I don't know. It might be time to go, check that out again. And, if I did, I would have to, pretty much put an end to the Forgecraft, or it would be yeah, we might do Forgecraft like once a week or twice a week or something like that, and slow this down considerably. But yeah, let me know what you think, because I'm still not sure that I even want to do that yet. I will go back to Terraformacraft someday. It's just a matter of do I go ahead and do it, or do I wait for the next big what they're calling the Kingdoms update, or do I wait for the rewrite, which is going to be, I don't know what he's going to call it, probably, you know, maybe, I think it's TFCraft 2 right now. I don't know. That's the working title. Maybe it's something different. I don't even know. But yeah, let me know what you'd like to see. And because I'm not the idea factory that some other people are, especially with mods. When I come up with something, I like to think it's really cool and ridiculous and fun. But I have trouble even doing a couple of 3 episodes a day, just because I don't have the ideas ready at hand. But I think we're ready for the next bit of Zycorium. I'm not sure that's even going to be enough to trigger it. We may have to go force it to run that filter. To run the loader. Okay, so it's still going there. Yeah, I don't think we're going to have enough. We're just going to have to force the issue. And we're going to wait until all of this is done. So it'll be just a second. Alright, last one there. Six remaining, and they all go up into there. And now, the system's idle. Nothing going on until we hit that. Yep, see, it's going to... Well, it actually should put it into one of these. Yep, there we go. So we should be okay for a little while. And it's almost got enough time. I should probably... Oh, yeah, see, there we go. And we're going to miss out on one of the Zycorium things here. That's okay. I may have to try to think of some way to fix that. Not sure how I would do it. Maybe it would run until 27 times, or the chest was empty. That might work. That could work. We'll just have to see. But from here on out, we're going to have just a very small remainder of Zycorium and other stuff in this chest. And as far as I know, that's really unavoidable. I don't know of any other way to, unless I just periodically... I mean, even if I did just periodically run these through, it might still not be enough to get a package. So we would have to, it would just, continuously cycle, and I don't want it to do that. But in the other system, in the other packaging system, each of where I had the big horseshoe of packagers, there were, up to 8 gold ingots in there, or 8 silver, or 8 diamonds, whatever was in there. So, it's going to be the same, basically the same amount of remainder left over in the system regardless. The only other thing that I can think of to do would be to wrap all of this in a sort of a one-time use circuit. And once it's done, once it's not detecting any more blocks to be done at all for a very long time, or... Yeah, we'd have to use item counters, and we could do that. We could wrap it up so it processes everything, and then dumps everything back out. But that's twice the storage. And it defeats the purpose of this whole making of the blocks and sending them through, is so I don't have to store, you know, these things too. So we're just going to leave this here and not worry about it at all. And it looks like we'll have enough to make one more block, out of, at least out of the dark side we're in. Five there. We probably won't have enough blue. We might have enough green. But, you know what, one or two blocks in here isn't worth the Zycorium in here isn't going to hurt us at all. Even with diamonds, once we start quarrying out a bunch of stuff, we won't have to worry about it at all. We won't even miss it. So, okay, we're just going to let that run then. And I'll come back and cover it all up later. Okay. But yeah, I was going to do some Thaumcraft stuff, but the R is high right now, so I guess I won't. Let's see. Where's my book? My book is always in some other location. I think I know where it is, though. You know what? That's all right. Let's do... Let's just try a few things. Go with levers. Oh, we got something. Okay, cool. Got some control going on. This is looking to be... I hope I don't run out of levers. Come on. Darn. What did I have? 42 to start with that? Good grief. What have we got? A decanting golem. That's interesting. Okay, let's see. Vacuum? No. No vacuum. Movement, more than likely. Yeah. Oh, come on. There we go. Am I at 50%? Oh, I'm not. Let's see. Is it a smart golem? Is it going to use water? It's going to use water and intelligence. Maybe. Or just water. Yeah, it's fine. We've got... Oh, it does use intelligence. Okay, we'll just do this then. And purity. Cool. And, let's see, I think I have some refined iron here. And yes, I could use, silverwood leaves for purity. I would rather break them, as I said, and find, and try to find saplings, and burn them on saplings, rather than, use them for research. Come on. Oh, don't run me out. There we go. Thank you. One left. Good grief. Expensive stuff here. What have we got? Tallow golems have proven themselves around the lab, but they can only refill crucibles, and transporting essentia is quite costly. There must be a way to make them smarter, less wasteful, and more flexible. And now I need to go find my book so I can read up on what these things actually do. I bet they don't require vials. Oh my god, where's my book? Come on. There we go. Must find... Oh, there it was. Easy enough. Alright. We're waiting for the motorcycle to arrive. Okay, it's the advanced golem. Okay, cool. They each carry around a warded jar that allows it to transport all known liquids. Each jar is large enough to carry 64 essentia or 4 buckets of other liquids. Neat. Cool. We don't have to waste files anymore. Okay, when placed on something capable of holding liquid, okay. So it holds a warded jar. Okay, so yeah, basically this is, oh, we need a strong telegolem worker. Okay, so this is going to be quite expensive to make. We won't be able to make one of these this time. But I'm definitely going to do one of these for my Essentia. Because that looks cool. And that way I won't have to worry about running out of vials or anything like that. That will be useful. Yep, we'll just have to wait for the aura to go down a little bit. What I may do... we need some spot loaders. Oh, that'll be easy enough to do. Oh, we get 10 now. Cool. Okay, so I'll make some spot chunk loaders. What I've heard is that as long as the Aura node itself is chunk loaded, then it will share with all of the other nodes in the area. So what I'm going to do probably is go around here and spot load all the nodes in this area, so the Flux and the Vis have a chance to even out. And that way, you know, both player and I can use this big node here and not have to worry too much about you know, getting in each other's way or blocking up the node for long amounts of time. Because I don't believe this one's going to actually load once everybody quits out of the game. So we'll do it that way. Okay. We should be about done with the packaging now. Yep, we are. So we've got a little over a stack, about a stack and a half of Zycorium blocks. Excellent. And I should do these as well. We can do these. We'll fool the system. Actually, we'll just dump these here into the iron chest. And those all should go pretty much to the same place that we pulled these out of. Yep, little bit of remainder, that's okay. Perfectly fine. Very cool. Very, very cool. So I guess I should put these also in the sorter. So let me grab out a few of these and one of those, and we'll put those in the sorting machine. Along with diamonds, may as well. Well, we'll do diamonds when we actually get some more. We'll save those. Why do I have two of these now? No. And there we go. Cool. And blue. Excellent. So now we should start to see the gem blocks show up. Yep, there they go. Excellent. Exactly as it should be. And so yeah, I will do the ingots as well. And go ahead and clear out all of the remainders and stuff and just set it up for when the quarry starts running, and everything will be good. Oh, I need to do some more extra dimensional chests, I believe. Or upgrades, barrel upgrades. And what I need to do is we'll probably do this for next time. We'll do a couple of recyclers and maybe set up a system directly under this for it to pull out all of the cobble in here and turn it into scrap. And then we'll just keep the scrap until we get our mass fab. But it will be, it'll be considerably less junk that we have to actually store. Because you get one scrap for about every 8 cobble. So, 8 per stack. And, yeah, so that's actually going to be quite a bit. But it should all still fit in a barrel. And I think it's all done. Excellent. What else can we do real quick? What's this? Ferrous ore? Yep. We're just going to leave that right where it is. Do I want to... No, I'm gonna pulverize that separately. We don't want to turn it into ingots. We just want to pulverize it. I wonder if it makes... Ooh. What am I doing here? I need some sand. I wonder if it gives a high chance of giving slag. It might. It just might. Eh. But these can be... I think these can be pulverized down. Yeah, they can. Yeah, okay, so we will, there's no reason not to put this in here with the rest of this stuff. So, there we go. All right. Go ahead and make the ingots and be done with it. Pulverized obsidian. Where did I keep that stuff? Here. Lead. There we go. Yeah, we may as well go ahead and do this. Just keep everything in ingots. I wonder if you can... do I have enough to try? I wonder if it'll even do this. I wonder, actually, we could probably check an NEI. There are no ferrous blocks. We've got molten ferrous. That's interesting. Okay, so there's no ferrous storage block. That's fine. Are we keeping? No, we're not. Actually, we are, because these are all going out here. So we'll just stick them... There should be a place. They should be showing up right where the ore was. Yep. And I have a couple of dull shards, so we can do something with that, I guess, once we find some ore. Now, there used to be a Thaumcraft machine that would let you make different kinds of shards, and hopefully that will be coming in soon. But it's not here yet, so we're just going to have to wait. We're just gonna have to wait and see. And raining. Alright, guys, I think I've rambled enough this time around. So we're gonna call this an episode, and we will be back next time with, hopefully, with some Thaumcraft stuff. Oh, we're down to moderate. Alright, let's see. What am I going to need? I got to do... Yeah, see, we got to do the golem and a brain in a jar and nitor and... Yeah, I will set all of this stuff up for next time. You guys know what it does. I need to do some more warded jars anyway, so... We will... be back. Come on. There we go. phone, whatever. We'll be back. Thanks for watching, guys. I really appreciate it. We'll talk to y'all next time. Bye-bye.